Hey guys, it's Julianne Doodles, and today we are creating DIY pins from the new Netflix original movie, The Mitchells vs. the Machines. First few things you'll need for this project are going to be a pencil, eraser, and something to draw on. Next, you'll need these acrylic pins I found on Amazon. They're super affordable and they come in a few sizes. Today, I'm going to be using the 1.8 inch acrylic pins, and that's just because I prefer a larger pin. For the first part of this quick and easy DIY project, we are going to grab the backing of the pins and we're going to use these dudes to outline the border of our drawings. This is also going to double as a cut line. And with the help of some very convenient editing magic, I've already sketched out all the drawings so that you guys would be spared from that boring process. The first pin we got going is going to be probably my favorite character of the whole movie, and that is Monchi the family pug. No pig. No pug. Pig. Definitely pug, we're gonna stick with it. I decided to go with Monchi because let's just be real, he is the real hero of the story and just the absolute cutest and wackiest looking dog I've ever seen. I mean, I just cannot stop staring at him. An absolute icon, if I may say so myself. The way Monchi is drawn really speaks to the super fun and weird style of animation in this movie. As a huge fan of animation myself, this movie was just everything to me. It is extremely quirky and unapologetic in its quirkiness, which just goes incredibly well with the theme and message of the movie. This movie really touched my heart and struck a nerve with me. On the outside, this movie is about an AI apocalypse, which I do weirdly think about from time to time given that I'm from Silicon Valley. The true story is about embracing your weird and the trials of growing up. Parents having to adjust to an ever-changing world that they might not completely understand anymore, and kids just beginning to try to understand it, while at the same time feeling misunderstood. The main character, Katie, is fun and quirky and oozing with creativity, and she's actually the one that rocks these pins in the movie. She's unapologetic in her style and who she is. Katie and her family embark on a road trip to save the world, and they do it in this amazing burnt orange 1993 station wagon. Not only is it falling apart, but you also have to know how to drive stick shift, which would mean that I would have been absolutely toast in this robot apocalypse. For this pin, I wanted to go with a design that was bright and fun, so I chose some neon markers for the projection lines that give the car a sense of motion. Next, I'll be working on this rainbow pin, which was ripped directly from the movie. Katie is seen rocking this pin throughout the entire story, and it just seemed right to have it represented in this DIY project. If you color outside the lines, don't worry about it. It's really not that big of a deal. We will be cutting out the circle anyway, so feel free to be loose with it. Now it's time to cut out our beautiful creations. For me, I'll have to rip it out of my sketchbook first, and then I'll cut away all the larger pieces. I find it way easier to cut this way because you won't have all the big loose paper getting in your way when you want a precise cut. Guess that's how I roll. So if you're ill at ease, you can stroll with me. Next, it's finally time to put our drawings into the acrylic pins. Take the top of the pin and place your drawing in it face side down. If the fit isn't quite right, go ahead and do a little trimming. If there's a really small border left, go ahead, just use your nail to crease it into the pin. This way, the entire surface of the pin will still remain covered and it still fits with the backing. Once you've fitted your drawing into the top side of the pin, go ahead and grab the backing. Make sure that the clip is parallel to your drawing and then snap it on. And there we have it, your very own The Mitchells versus the Machines inspired pins. Inside these acrylic pins, they should be waterproof and they'll look great on basically anything. Personally, I like putting my pins on my backpack or my tote bag, and we can also just rock the Katie Mitchell look by grabbing a red jacket and sticking these bad boys on there. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I hope you guys have some fun creating these pins. See you next time.